We often talk about gases as being made up of very small particles zooming about and bouncing off each other, as well as the walls of their container. But how fast are these particles actually moving? Let's find out. Hello there, I'm Parth, and I like to make fun physics videos, so if you enjoyed this one, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more fun physics content. So, particles moving in a gas. How fast do they actually move relative to the walls of their container? Well, if we're studying an ideal gas, more on that in a second, then its particles move at a range of different speeds, some slowly and some more quickly. The distribution of particle speeds for an ideal gas is given by what's known as the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. As always, this looks like a really complicated equation, but there's only a few things we need to know about it. Firstly, the function takes into account things like the mass of the particles of gas that we're studying, m, and the temperature of the gas, T. All the other quantities on the right-hand side of this equation, apart from v, the speed, are just constants. They help us scale this equation to make sure we get the right values for each gas and temperature that we study. What this equation shows is a probability density function. All that means is that if we plot this function f on the vertical axis and speed v on the horizontal axis, then the area under the graph between two speeds v1 and v2 gives us the probability of finding particles in our gas that are moving with a speed in that range. So we're more likely to find particles in this speed range than this speed range, even though the range in speed is exactly the same. Now, the interesting thing about this graph is that it clearly shows some particles moving relatively slowly, a large number of particles moving at this modal speed here, and then fewer and fewer particles moving at faster and faster speeds. This graph never actually touches the horizontal axis, which suggests that we have some small probability of a particle moving really extremely fast, well beyond the speed of light even. But it's worth remembering that this graph is a mathematical model representing a group of real particles. In truth, there will be one particle that happens to have the fastest speed of all in the gas, and it's very unlikely that that speed is faster than the speed of light. Nevertheless, this mathematical model works really well for the very large majority of particles making up our gas. And I reckon what we're looking for is the actual value of the modal speed, the speed at which we're likely to find the most number of particles moving. Because as we've seen, there are always going to be some particles moving much faster, but most particles will be moving at around this speed. So what is this value? An easy way to calculate this is to plot this probability density function with specific mass and temperature values. For example, let's assume that we're studying helium gas at room temperature, which is around 25 degrees Celsius or 298 Kelvin. When we plug in those values, our probability density function looks like this, with the modal speed being somewhere around 1100 to 1200 meters per second. That's around 4000 kilometers per hour or 2500 miles per hour. Super fast. And remember, many particles will be moving even faster than this. But I think what's even more interesting is thinking about what happens if we consider different gases or different temperatures. Let's start with temperature. If we increase the temperature of the gas, then the probability density function shifts to look more like this. Firstly, we see that the modal speed increases. This makes sense because a higher temperature means particles will be generally moving faster. We also see that the probability density of the modal speed decreases, however. This also makes sense because we're modeling the same number of particles in our gas, just at a higher temperature. This means more particles will be moving faster than with the lower temperature gas, and so there's a bigger range of particle speeds from zero to whatever the fastest is, and hence fewer particles moving at the same speed. Next, let's think about what happens with different gases, but now all at the same temperature. What's relevant here is the mass of the particles. We studied helium gas before, but we can also apply this probability density function to gases whose particles have more mass, for example, oxygen, which is molecules made up of two oxygen atoms. As we consider gases with particles of higher mass, the distribution shifts this way. On average, the particles move more slowly. This makes sense because if the two gases are at the same temperature, then the one with the heavier molecules will generally result in those molecules moving more slowly. The last thing worth mentioning about this distribution is that it's a mathematical model based on the assumption that our gas is an ideal gas. An ideal gas is a simplified model of a real gas that assumes that the particles of the gas are perfect point masses and don't actually have any size. It also assumes that the particles don't interact with each other at all, neither by exerting forces on each other, as charged particles would or particles with charges would, nor by colliding with each other. They just pass through each other. Though in some cases we can allow the particles to collide with each other if we say the collisions are perfectly elastic and no energy is wasted or transferred as heat during these collisions. In any case, no real gas behaves like this. All real gas particles have some spatial size, they're not infinitely small point masses, and all gas particles exert forces on each other through collisions and also through electromagnetic interactions. However, there are some conditions where real gases behave more and more like ideal gases, and in those cases, the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution becomes a more and more accurate description. If you'd like to learn more about that, then check out this video I made on the channel previously. I'll leave a link in the description as well, if you're interested. The distribution can also be changed to represent more realistic gas particles, but that discussion is more complicated and deserves a video of its own. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see that. The important thing is that we've discovered that gas particles move around extremely quickly, around 1200 meters per second for helium particles at room temperature, and many of them move even faster. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more fun physics content. Please hit the bell button if you'd like to be notified every time I upload. I'd like to say a huge thanks to all of my Giga patrons and all of the other patrons over on my Patreon page. I'll leave a link to that in the description if you'd like to support me on there. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you very soon.